It'll truly be Christmas for me when this is over with. For the sake of my blood pressure, hopefully it's not a barn burner like the previous game was. But, you know, I guess we'll just have to see. Lemon ginger tea sucks. Well, that could have been worse. Could have gone either way, if you ask me. Oh well. Moving on. Oh, come on.
And it'll be fourth down following the pass deflection.
And those are the kind of big third down plays you have to have on defense to get the ball back and give your team a chance on offense.
And it calls for the fair catch at the 26-yard line. They'll get the ball here at the 26-yard line. It's first and 10.
Oh, damn it.
And just about 4 yards away here on second
down. Shit.
He's in trouble, and he can't hold on to the ball.
Well, that might not. Okay. Well, it certainly could have been worse. Holy shit, that's pathetic. Oh, fuck off.
Around the 30-yard line, by number 33. Gives it up the cut. He's dropped down at about the 25-yard line by Moala. He puts it on the run. Indianapolis falls on it, and they have the turnover.
The wide receivers are so used to making jukes and moves out there, and sometimes they just get loose with the football. That one stripped away, and that's a big play.
On the ground, up the middle, Joey Porter was there for the stop. 4 yards on the carry.
This is a battle of fucking complete ineptitude. I think we just need to let this quarter run out. Maybe the second quarter will rid us of our complete fucking ineptitude.
another handoff. Harry Rose was there to bring him down.
Joseph Addai is really the perfect back for this style of offense. Of course, they have the ability to spread the field with a passing game. You see a lot of nickel and dime coverage against this passing game. So now you're creating some rushing lanes for Joseph Addai, and he really takes advantage of it. Joseph Addai represents really everything a team could want in a running back. He always fights for the extra yardage. You never see him just running out of bounds. He's a tough guy. He's a great athlete. What a force.
Indianapolis up 7 points. McAfee is just about ready to kick this one away. Number 36 stands back to field the kick.
Jesus Christ.
Good coverage downfield. Looking.
Oh, fuck off. This is going to be a battle of who is least inept. Oh, come on. Well, we can't really hope for another fumble, but we can at least hold him to a field goal. Okay, this isn't going to happen. Well,
just missed that time, bringing him down for a sack, but great pressure to force an incompletion.
He's searching for a receiver. Decides to run for it. Touchdown, Arizona.
And the thing defensive coordinators hate more than anything else is a quarterback that can run the football. It just seems like you have so much more to defend. That time he made a nice run.
Feeling the extra point. Arizona is ready to kick it away. Number 20 is deep, looking to return the kickoff. And it's fielded at the 4. He makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Davis was there for the stop. He's looking towards the left side.
Good decision at all.
I hate you, Chris Collinsworth. Please die.
Looks right. Throw. The pass is tipped. Surveys the field. He's loose and running strong. Darrell Washington was there to bring him down. Everything seemed to work perfectly on that one.
And that's a pattern that this team likes to run. You know they've been studying that all week on film, and yet they still can't stop. Well, you have to admire his courage. He's not afraid to make any throw, any time, anywhere, but he's lucky that one wasn't picked off.
Goes through his progression. And the tackle was made by Adrian Wilson.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about one like that being intercepted. Nobody on the defensive side could have got that bullet.
Okay, I should have seen that coming.
See how fast that linebacker was on that one. Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Still looking for an open man. The stop was made by Kerry Rose. The Colts will take their second time out of the half.
Halftime. You are gonna get fucked right in the butt, Ed Leslie.
Quickensteiner! Are we really fucking doing this? Thank you. Let's take a trip to the desert. Or, wait, I don't know. It's the Cactus Jack thing. Just fuck him. Fuck Mr. Benoit.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is proof. Anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation.
In fact, last time we fucked up and couldn't find a way to combine problems. However, now we don't need to do that. So instead, what we're gonna do is combine venues. Give me one moment. Alright, so it'll be Cactus Jack and Stone Cold Steve Austin, who won the WCW Championship from Kurt Angle on the October 8, 2001 edition of Raw from Indianapolis, against Shawn Michaels, who was born in Arizona. Don't let the billing fool you. And Chris Benoit. Which is not a part of the series. That will continue on in the next game. But, you know. It's a team sport. We gotta have a team match, right? Steve! Well, I suppose we can make things a little bit more interesting here. Whoever wins just to pick the stipulation of the next match. Mr. Benoit has already been itching for a cage match, whereas Captain Jack is not. Mm-hmm.
Between the tackles. He's brought down right around the 40-yard line by number 33. Looking for a man. He's going to his right. Throws.
And as a quarterback in this league, if you don't burn the blitz, if you don't come up with big plays, they are going to keep bringing it until you find some answers.
On the drive with the tailback. Matt Ingram was there to bring him down.
You can just tell he was not going to the ground until he got past that first down mark. But I really like the determination in this guy in picking up first downs.
Good coverage down deep. It's picked up.
Another one. I think they're going to count it on the catch. Yeah, god damn it. They're really benefiting from the Madden special today. They're just playing like shit for getting that one big play to keep the drive alive. Why could you tell me that now?
Receiver.
Could have been worse. I'll take it. Why the fuck do they get this slow asshole as the chip return guy? Isn't the chip return guy supposed to be fast and good? Nice. Well, 2011 season was a bit of a different story for Mr. Manning. Just a bit. Fuck was that? Oh. Never mind, I guess I'll read it later. So plenty of time for them to score again, but... getting that 1 yard score... wasting a little bit of time... helped. They don't seem keen on winning now.
Moves to his right. Has a man.
Yeah, me too. You fucking left it. You're fucking with me. Oh, that was a little bit longer than I thought. Embarrassing. If they hadn't fumbled, they could have had a chance here. Because we've both been fairly fucking inept all day.
Makes the grab near the sideline, but no signal yet.
Okay, they've given up. That's good. Thanks. It wasn't originally.
Hand off up the middle. Nice gain of 9 yards. Again. There he goes! Feet don't fail me now! They're in again for another touchdown.
Joseph Adai is one of the very players of the league. He brings the spark to his offense, as we can see now in plays like that. He just had gifts.
Point after is good. McAfee is ready to kick it away. Number 36 stands back to field the kick. Down to the end zone for a touchback. They were forced to punt on their last drive. Looks left. Here's a short pass.
Oh, fuck off.
23-yard line, 5 hours.
God, you fucking bastards. Oh, did they call a timeout or something? What assholes. Cool.
And let's take a look at the Gatorade performer of the game.
I already know who it is. They're probably gonna lie and say it's a dive, but it's definitely Hayden. Next game. No game. No more games this week. Looks like it's Minnesota Green Bay on Sunday, January 2nd. At least that's what I'm gathering from the schedule. In any event, get out.